Welcome students, the students of standard 8, and welcome you to the class. We have been studying about the history chapter number 4 and discussing about the different tribal groups living in different parts of India. We have studied about the tribal groups who lived in the eastern India, and we have also seen about their revolts, especially the revolt of the Santals, the Mundas and the Kons. Today we are going to discuss about the tribal people who lived in the northeastern India and their revolt. So today we are going to discuss about the Khasis, the revolt by the Khasis. These Khasis lived in the states of the Meghalaya. Mainly they lived in the state of Meghalaya. This is the northeastern states after Assam. After Assam comes the Meghalaya, and in this state, the hill regions of Meghalaya, these Khasis lived. They lived in the regions between the Garo and Gentai hills. This Garo hill is in the states of Assam in Guwahati, and Gentai hills in the states of Meghalaya. So these people lived in the parts of the Assam and Meghalaya. Now, the reason for their revolt. The reason for the revolt was the construction of a road by the British between the Brahmaputra Valley to Surma Valley. That was the main reason why this Khasis revolted against the British government. The British officer named David Scott. British officers named David Scott, who was in charge of looking after the northeastern territories when the British government controlled Assam. And after controlling Assam, getting the control of Assam, when David Scott, he was in charge of controlling the different states of northeastern India, he had a proposal for constructing a road. So David Scott, he wanted to construct a road between the Brahmaputra Valley to Surma Valley. Brahmaputra Valley is in Guwahati in Assam, and Surma Valley is in Silchar. It is the border of the Bangladesh. So this Surma Valley in present day in Bangladesh. So David Scott, a British officer, wanted to construct a road from Guwahati to Silchar. It is also the border of Bangladesh and a part of Assam. But the problem is, the construction of road has to be passing through the state of Meghalaya, because when we go from Assam to Silchar, definitely we have to pass through the middle of the state of Meghalaya. So this David Scott, this officer, he had a meeting with the local ruler of the Khasis. His name was U Tirat Singh. So U Tirat Singh, he was the leader or the local ruler of the Khasis. So David Tirat Singh, when having meeting with this David U Tirat Singh, he convinced him that they need to build a road from Guwahati to Silchar for the better movement, for the communication and transportation. So that was the reason he gave to the U Tirat Singh, and made him convinced for giving the rights to construct a road which will pass through their region. But the main reason for construction of road for the perspective of British was to control the northeastern areas. British mainly wanted to control this northeastern state so that they can easily move from these areas. They can move to these different states in northeastern parts, and they can easily have a control of this area. That was the main reason of the British why they wanted to construct a road. So when they started constructing a road from Guwahati to Silchar, around 230 km, the road was around 230 km when they started constructing this road, and they reached the states of this Meghalaya. These Khasis people, they revolted. The main reason for this revolt was that when they understood that once they construct a road through their region, they will definitely, the British will take control of their region. British will take control of their states, their areas, and they will put a tax on them. So understanding this problem, they were alarmed because of these things, and they opposed the construction of the this road. So they started a revolt. This revolt was started in 1849 and ended in 1851 when Tirot Singh, he was arrested by the British government. So that was the revolt of the Khasis, which was fought in the states of Meghalaya. Next was the revolt by the Kukis. That is the next revolt by the, before that we are going to see about the revolt by the Nagas. Nagas revolt, this Nagas lived in the region between the Assam and Burma. These are the areas where Naga people lived. They lived mainly in between the area of Assam and Burma. In 1820, Assam came under the control of the British. Reason for the revolt. The reason for the revolt, when this British, they prevented the Nagas from raiding the plains. Now these Nagas, they were controlling the different plain areas. They were taking control, they were raiding. They were raiding, actually, in other words, we can say they were capturing the different plain areas of Assam. So when these Nagas people, they were raiding the different plain areas and capturing those plain areas, British people wanted to stop them because this Assam and different areas were under the control of the British people. So British people wanted to control this raiding by the the Naga people. So when they forbade the Nagas from raiding the plains, these Naga people revolted against the British government. This revolt started in 1849 and ended in 1851. So that was the revolt when British government, they suppressed this revolt, and the revolt ended. Next we see the revolt by the Kukis. The Kukis lived in the hill ranges of the Manipur and Tripura. Reason for the revolt was the unjust agricultural and cheap labor policies. So that was the main reason of the Kukis. These Kukis people lived in the region, hill ranges of the Manipur and Tripura. Especially these are also the hill ranges, the hilly areas. So when the reason for the revolt, the main reason for the revolt was the unjust agricultural policies. Unjust agricultural policies, because this people of this Kukis people, the people of this Manipur and Tripura, they mainly practice the jhum cultivation or the shifting cultivation, because they lived in the forest areas, in the hilly areas. Therefore, they cleaned the patches of land to cultivate the crops. But when British people, they got control of this area, they wanted to stop these people from practicing jhum or shifting cultivation. Therefore, these Kukis people, they revolted against the British government. And also the main reason was the tax which was put on these people. So this was the reason why these people revolted against the British government in the year 1829 and also in the 1845 and 1849. These revolts were fought in different times, in different years by the Kukis people, but finally they were suppressed by the British government. So that was the revolt which was fought in different northeastern states of India. We also see this, there were different revolts in different parts of India. Not only this eastern India, not only in north eastern India, but also we see different parts of India, there were different revolts by the different tribal people. We also have the revolt by the Naikadas in the parts of Gujarat, in Madhya Pradesh, and also in Rajasthan. Revolt of the Koya and Konda tribes, and revolt by the Bhil people of the Maharashtra and in the Gujarat and the people of the Madhya Pradesh. So these all revolts were mainly the main reason for the unjust agricultural policy of the British. The British, their main reason was, main purpose was to gain the maximum revenue from these people, and therefore they put a high tax on the land, and which was very difficult for these people to pay the high revenue to the British government. and also the different policies of the unjust policies which made these people to lose their lands. They became the landless laborer, and their labor, most of these tribal peoples, when they were taken by the British to work as a labor in different fields, their payment, the payment was also very less. They were paid very less, and as a result their life was miserable. When their life was miserable, and these people, they fought against the British government. But this, because these people mainly fought with their old weapons, especially the bows and arrows, which could not stand against the sophisticated guns and all other weapons used by the British government, and therefore these all revolts were suppressed by the British government. In these revolts, many of the leaders, many of the tribal people, they lost their lives, and finally these revolts came to an end. So students, you understood these things about the tribal peoples living in, still there are many tribal people lives in different parts of India. So we have seen their revolts and why they revolted, and ultimately the results. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for this class.